Okay. My last question, sir, is what happens if the Vice President refuses to attend? Will the House order number, ito muna, for the four, are you able to issue an arrest warrant against them? Is that a possibility?
Yes, they were already cited in contempt. So, yun na po yung consequence nun. So, they will be arrested. But on the part of the Vice President, we did not invite her actually. Dahil ayaw naman niya mag-take ng oath eh. So, what's the use of inviting her? But of course, she's always welcome to attend the committee as long as mag-take siya ng oath. Otherwise, kung hindi rin naman siya mag-take ng oath, so what's the use?
So the last time she attended, she did not take an oath.
She did not take an oath. Now, if you're not hiding anything, so ano naman ang ikatatakot mo kung bakit hindi ka mag-oath?
Okay. Anything you want to add, sir, before we go? I want to thank you for this interview today. Anything you want to add?
Well, Karen, ito naman talaga ginagawa natin primarily. In aid of legislation. And because of this, dito nga sa committee hearing na ito, marami na tayong nakikita na mga loopholes natin sa batas. That's why we're trying to fix it. So, as I said a while ago, yun na nga yung isa sa mga nakikita ko talaga, we have to limit. We have to pass a law that will limit agencies or department who na dapat bibigyan ng mga ganitong klaseng pondo because otherwise, masasayang lamang ito.
On that note, I want to thank you so much, Congressman Joel Chua, for joining me today, sir. I hope to have you again on Head Start. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen.